Lady Anna and King Rocco presents Heart to Heart, a spicy, sizzling extravaganza where, before launching into your emotions, consider asking your partner if it's a good time to discuss how you feel. Talking about your feelings builds trust and intimacy. Exploring your emotions will help you unravel the complexity of what you are feeling and can be done with heartfelt chats with your partner.
So listeners,
take this opportunity and join us
every other Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern Caribbean time,
for Heart to Heart with Lady Anna
and King Rocco HD on UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together.
Yes, indeed. Welcome, great people, to another, I tell you people, it's going to be beautiful. Another edition of Art to Art and UVC Radio, the sound that brings us together. I'm your producer, Marco 18, and the beautiful, beautiful, attractive lady, Anna, in the building. We're ready to go. Just that you guys have a blessed and wonderful day today. And, you know, you guys definitely look forward for Art to Art tonight. Before we do, let me get my co-host in the building right now. Good evening to you, Anna. What's up? How you doing?
Good evening, King Rocco, and good evening to our listeners. Good afternoon, good morning. And yes, we're now coming out of the throwback and straight into Heart to Heart. It is always a delight to have King Rocco with us in studio. So I am doing fantastic. What about you, Rocco? How has it been for you?
You know, I mean, leaps and bounds, but, you know, we're still pressing on and stuff like that. You know, it's another episode here right now tonight. And, you know, I'm really looking forward for the topic tonight because, you know, I believe it is special tonight, to be honest with you. So, you know, it's a pleasure being sitting once again with you in studio for another beautiful program tonight. So, yeah.
All right. And the listeners, by now, I know that most of us are getting ready to celebrate Mother's Day. Some individuals have already started with their posts on Facebook, on their WhatsApp, their status and so on, and hustling around doing last minute shopping, putting stuff together, ingredients for your delicious meals with your mom, or if you are a mother celebrating with your children. So that is what we will be speaking about this evening. It's a tribute to mother.
Oh, most definitely it is. And you know, before we even proceed, want to say a big shout out to all of the super moms out there, you know what I mean?
Oh, Okay, yes. So listeners, as we get into the topic for this evening, we've got some video clips to share with you. Well, descriptive clips that will be heard. So we are going to go straight into the first one. And what's the name of the first one, Rocco, that we will be sharing with the audience? Okay, yes. So as Rocco cues that one up, we are going to be listening to a mom giving birth to a baby. And then we're going to get into all that great stuff about moms and what moms do. And who knows, maybe we will hear a little bit about Rocco and all the women who were a great part of his life and his bringing up, all the mother figures, his mom as well. So stay tuned, yeah, as we go into the first clip.
Absolutely, let's get into this right now.
Good morning, honey. I'm sorry, I didn't make you breakfast. But our son did.
Da, da, da. Happy Mother's Day, Mommy.
Oh, honey, this is so great. Are you the sweetest? Thank you, sweetheart.
I helped a little bit on the eggs, but he did the toast all by himself.
Well, this is the best toast I've ever had.
Really?
Yes, really. I am so lucky to be your mommy. The day you were born was the best day of my life.
What was it like?
The day you were born, it was amazing.
Okay, only a few more centimeters and you'll be ready, okay?
Oh my God, how much bigger can the hole get?
Just breathe.
The vagina hurts!
Were you scared, Mommy?
Oh no, I was excited. I had a big smile on my face the whole time. Didn't I?
Oh, yeah.
Guys, we're going to have to perform an episiotomy.
No, don't cut my butthole in
half. Mommy, were you scared?
Why does it look like that?
You're not a man.
No, but daddies don't get scared.
I'm not ready.
You're not a man.
Then what happened?
The nice doctor came in and told us it was time.
So I think
where have you been, you stupid whore?
And then she told me to give one little push.
He's having one more push.
My pooping!
No, no, baby, no!
Yes.
It's okay.
And one little push, and you were born. And you were the most beautiful baby in the whole world.
Why does he look like that? Why is he yellow? Is that normal?
And that's what happened on the best day of my life. And you know what else? Every day since then has been better than the day before.
Babe, where's my hockey stuff?
It's in the hall closet.
He woke up, by the way.
I get a drink after.
I love you, Mommy.
Oh, I love you too, honey.
Mommy?
Yeah?
I had an accident last night.
Oh, well, I'm sure Daddy cleaned it up.
No, I wanted you to clean it.
Honey, we fall in love by chance. To stay in love by choice.
In your eyes lies the beauty of the night. Our love grows great when our souls intertwine.
I am Lady Anna.
And I am King Rocco HD.
Where it takes two
to tango.
Lady, can and go with me to a special place where we can have a little privacy. What I wanna say to you is so easy to do.
Talk to me.
'Cause you're my world, my everything, my dream come true. Ever since we've been together, there were days of stormy weather. With love on our side, we always made it through. Time to take it one step further. Time for
yes, yes, people, welcome back to Heart to Heart and UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. I'm your old King Rocco HD, and we got the beautiful Lady Anna in the studio, and also a special guest join us from all across the world. So without further ado, let me get back my co-host in the studio. Welcome back, Lady Anna.
Oh, yes, yes, King Rocco, I am here with you, yes, listeners, and we are back after taking in that enterprising video clip there about a mother. And as we get in into the discussion about who is a mother, let us introduce our guest first, because you may hear him interjecting into the conversation sometime soon. So Rocco, let's introduce him, and then
yes, definitely
the meat of the matter.
Definitely, we'll introduce a special guest on tonight from all the way from Accra, Ghana, who is a radio presenter as well. Work with the Ghana Broadcasting Service down there in Accra. Festos, brother, I apologize, I can't pronounce your last name, but goes by the name of Festus. Welcome, my friend.
Yes, Ken Roku. Thank you very much. And Lady Anna, thank you so much. I hope you're all doing very well.
Most certainly. What time is it out there in Ghana?
Yeah, so it's past 12. That's roughly around 15 minutes, roughly past 12 a.m. in Ghana.
Oh, midnight.
Thank you for being a part of so late to listen to us and be a part of us. We appreciate that.
Most definitely,
definitely
we do.
Most definitely, right.
It is certainly nice to have you joining us.
Thank you so much. It's a
pleasure. Most definitely. We're going to hear a little bit more from you momentarily. So, Anna, continue with what you were saying.
Okay, so listeners, we're going to share a little bit about who is a mother. And please feel free to share your comments with us, your views with us via WhatsApp. Or if you wish to join in the conversation, you can come into the Zoom and be part of the discussion this evening. So let us just picture there is a pregnant mom, and her hands form a heart shape on top of her tummy. So we're gonna say mother, mama, or just plain mom. Those are just some of the names of the women in our lives that will help raise us and love us unconditionally, forever and always. And my dear listeners, we all know that moms endure the good, the bad, and the ugly from their children. And always, no matter what we hand out to them, but they always hand back to us hugs and kisses, no matter what. They are the rock and the support throughout the good and the bad times. So we all know that about moms. And throughout our lifetime, a mommy will always hold us near and dear to her heart while wiping away our tears. A mother will kiss our worries away and make us smile. A mother will try and take all our pain and sorrow away and make them hers. And we're just going to look at real moms. Now, all moms are real moms in our eyes. Huh? But what is it really? What is it really like to be a mom, to be a mother? And, listeners, we mean really and truly open your feelings and mind and state the truth. Is it all roses and sunshine? Is it okay not to be crafty or to lose your patience? Do you have to volunteer at the school every month? Or can you just lounge at home and eat Oreos and drink milk on the couch during the school Halloween party or Christmas treat? So we are here this evening to tell the truth about being a mom. And while we are at it, what is a true mom? First off, you know something, Rocco and Festus, and as well as our listeners, moms come in all shapes and sizes and even genders. I say this because the list of moms is never ending. There is the biological mother, the foster mother, the stepmother, the single mother, the single father, the grandparents, and so much more. A mother is a caregiver, an unconditional love giver, a housekeeper, a cooker, a baker, a taxi driver, a psychologist, a doctor, a discipliner. They are the ones who bear the burden of everything, good and bad, as the days grow on. They are the ones who may get left behind, as they do so much. They don't get as much appreciation. And so this evening here on this program, we are going to have a tribute to mom. And now that we have King Rocco and Festus, we are going to share and speak a little bit about how Mother's Day is celebrated in Ghana as well as the Caribbean, and about the figures in our lives that endure that role of mother and grandmother. So I am sure we have lots of stories to tell tonight.
Definitely, Lady Anna. I'm sure we have a lot of stories to tell our listeners, and I know they are really going to join whatever that we are going to say as part of our celebrations and all that. So definitely it's going to be an interesting program, and then I hope they will really enjoy it. Yeah.
Okay, so Festus, let's start with you. You want to tell us a little bit about how Mother's Day is celebrated in Ghana?
Yeah, so it's not too ordinary. It's not too different from what is done across the world in Ghana. So it normally falls on Sunday, so we go to church. There are services that are organized for mothers in the various churches. So from there, if you decide that you want to send your mom outside to probably to give her best of treats, or to send her to the poolside, or to send her to an eatery, it depends on you and your pocket. But basically, it is just celebrated just like the way it's done across the world. Nothing too special, because mothers are very special in our lives. So for me, over the years, what I do is I normally get her gifts. And then on Sundays, I do special cooking for my mama. I mean, we are four boys and a girl. So what we do is we all come to the house. We all drive to mommy's house. And then before she returns from church, her favorite food is prepared and we all eat together. And we share all the memories growing up as kids. The way we were troublesome, you know, especially me, I was really troublesome. I was giving mommy a hell of a time, you know. Don't go here, I will go. Don't do this, I will do. And it's like all the time people would say, oh, this is your son. He has an eye problem and he's not behaving as if he has an eye problem. And mommy will come and beat me. And the next day I'll go do the same thing. So, you know, I've really given mommy a hell of a time. But irrespective of whatever that I did, yeah, she still loves me as a child. And now being a grown man as I am, sometimes she sits me down and says, I just hope your children will not behave like the way you used to do when you were a kid, you know. You know, and since then, I've been that calm of a person. And I remember the last time when Mother's Day, last year, I went with my daughter. And she was telling my daughter that, your father has been a naughty boy before. Don't do this, you will do it. Don't do that. So I hope you will not behave like your father. I said, oh, Grandma, don't tell granddaughter that. Because, look, he knows that the daddy is a very good man. And we all laughed over it. But, hey, it's been just like what is done across the world. But this year, I really want to celebrate my mom because, in fact, my mom has been my backbone. She's everything to me. I mean, I can't replace her. I always pray to God that God should give her an extra, maybe 10 years. My mom is 72 years, and I pray that God should give her an extra, maybe 10 years or 15 years, so that whatever that she's always dreamt of, because she sacrificed for us, you know, whatever that she has to eat, she'll sacrifice for us. She has to sell just to put us to school. And to be frank with you, five of us, all of us have been to the university, and we are well to do. We are, I mean, doing in all our various fields. And sometimes when we get home, it's like she weeps. It's like, oh God, I'm so grateful for, I mean, sending all my kids to school and putting them where they are today. So trust me, Sunday will be, we'll reminisce all the good memories when we're growing up. And I know my mom will be a happy woman once again this year around.
Amen to that. Okay. So Rocco, you want to share with us a little bit about Mother's Day on your end? Growing up with mom?
Oh, most certainly. A while ago, you made a comment. You say you got mummies in different form, mothers in different form. I can honestly say to you, I had quite a few mamas, to be honest with you. Biological, godmother, aunties that will consider possibly to be mother, grandmother, great-grandmother. Mm-hmm. And for me personally, to be honest with you, I can honestly say I've been truly blessed. You know, I'm the first child from my mother, and also I'm the first great grand as well, too, and also the first grandchild as well, too. So,
wow.
Oh yes. I mean, I'm the first right through the line, you know what I'm saying? And for me, I mean, growing up as a kid and stuff like that. And well, with my mother, you know, it's anytime like Mother's Day or a birthday or anything of such for me, you know, it has always been a special moment and stuff like that. As Festus rightly said, you know, your mother will try that much, try very hard to make sure, to keep you in check, make sure everything is right, make sure there's food on the table, make sure you're going to school neat and stuff like that. Thank God, you know, my mom was there, but at a certain point, you know, my mom went abroad and stuff like that. And, you know, I continue to live with my grandma. My grandma, and I mean, the time that we spend together is truly, truly remarkable. I mean, words just can't really express. I mean, none of them no longer here right now. Both great grandma and also my grandma, they're no longer here. But the time that I spent with these women that had such a pivotal role in my upbringing, it was truly, truly amazing. I mean, We do a lot of stuff together. I mean, well, back in those days, I mean, I was pretty young, so I won't say, I mean, I was cooking for them or anything of such. You know what I'm saying? But in anything that, you know, I can do, always be there at their side and stuff like that. Sometimes they want me to do anything for them, you know, they were calling me and stuff like that. You know, I'm always there. And even though into the latter years, you know, even though we all, you know, been living in different countries, and stuff like that, both my mother, great grandmother, grandmother, all of us kind of separate different part of the world. But one of the thing, you know, we use the telephone and stuff like that to communicate much as possible. And you know, anytime we communicate, you know, it's always an amazing feeling, to be honest with you. With my mother, I would truly say, I mean, oh God, I would truly say remarkable, to be honest with you, man, because my mom, I would say, having two kids at a young age, maybe 19 years old or 18 years old and stuff, like she was pretty young herself, and trying to get into the nursing, becoming a nurse and stuff like that, it wasn't no fun. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't no fun back in those days. But she did. She have done everything and anything possible under the sun, basically to keep us together and stuff like that. And you know, for me personally, those special moments that we add over the years, it's gonna always resonate in my heart. We do communicate from time to time. I mean, we don't live in the same environment and stuff like that, but you know, whenever we do speak and whenever we do kind of like get close to each other and stuff like that, you know, it is good. It's a really good thing. And for my mother, I mean, I can honestly say to you guys as well, too, in terms of respect, she have great, great respect for me. one thing she don't do, trying to trespass of anything of me. If I say certain things and whatnot, yeah, she do listen. And because you see, one of the thing, the communication that we have, you know, it's not a situation. Sometimes people look at us like, oh, is this mother and son? We like friends. We talk like friends. You know what I'm saying? We hang out together, you know. We have done a lot of stuff together. Unfortunately, I mean, I put it publicly. You know, I don't call my mom. I don't. I call her by her name, by her birth name. I don't.
Wow.
I don't know. I don't know, probably because of the situation, you know. I mean, well, she had me that young and stuff like that. And you know, like, or possibly because, you know, I've not, like, most of my life, like, we lived together. Because again, as I said, you know, she was overseas, she was in a different country, I was in a different country and stuff like that. And you know, when we do communicate, when we do get together, maybe like sometime when she come back, maybe like every year or every other year or so. But I mean, nevertheless, by saying that, you know, the relationship is there. And it's you know, a true, as I said, you know, it's truly amazing, truly, truly amazing. I can call her up, and we can sit down and talk as friends. We can talk just about anything under the sun. You know what I'm saying? I mean, sometime maybe I get on the nerves. I will say like years ago and stuff like that. And one of the thing, I can honestly say it to say as well to the listener, instead of like my mom whipping me, hell no. 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 My mom, she did, yes, but I had a granddaddy. You know, he never used to play with me. I mean, one time my mom gonna hit me, and my grandfather stood up towards and said, "If you only touch him, I'll whip you today." Yeah, so I was always sheltered and always protected by my folks, like my great grandma as well too. As a kid and stuff like that, you know. You know, she was a businesswoman, and you know, different countries, different places that, you know, she traveled to. You know, I'm always there with her. She always have me beside her and stuff like that. You know, these are some of the moments, as I would tell the listener, you know, man, I just can't forget that. I just can't. My grandmother, likewise, God bless her soul. some of her kids used to be like upset sometimes because they always like, you know what? Everything for you is all about your grandson, your grandkids. She was truly a remarkable woman as well. God bless her soul. You know, I mean, ain't nothing that I ever wanted in life, or if I ever call on her, that she was never, that she was not there. She was not there for me. Not at all. The last time I saw both my great grandma and grandmother is like over 7 years ago. And again, as I said, they all live in different country. And the sad thing for me, what was really hard for these people that had played such a pivotal role in my life. Unfortunately, the world experienced something that we never experienced before, COVID in 2020. And both of them passed away around that time. And both of these people that had such a great impact in my life, you know what I'm saying? I just unfortunately couldn't even go to none of the funeral because all borders were locked, can't even travel or anything of such. So for me personally, that was really, really, really hard. Really hard because, you know, to see these people have been there for you and, you know, just the last moment of their life, you're just not even there. That was really hard for me. But overall, overall, I have had, you know, some really important, female in my life that I can look up to and call mom, to be honest with you. I mean, there's a whole lot more, but I don't want to take up too much time.
Wow.
Okay, so thanks for sharing that, Rocco. At least we learned a bit more about you and your mom. And we got to know about Festus and his mom, a little bit about his siblings and so. And but Rocco, in terms of like the actual Mother's Day and so, how do you guys celebrate, maybe in your part of the world or wherever you were at, whichever part of the world?
Well, you know, it's a regular thing, you know, to be honest with you. Sometime I wonder, Mother's Day seems to become bigger than Christmas. Big up all the moms out there, but sometime, hey, I hope Father's Day come, y'all treat us the same way as well. Yeah, just don't give us a hammer and a gloves.
That's what there's something we call positive discrimination. So don't expect the way fathers will be celebrated when mothers are celebrated. So positive discrimination.
I hear you, Festus. I hear you. Yeah, but you know, Mother's Day is the same regular typical thing that, you know, most persons would do. You know, sometime, you know, you buy your mom a nice perfume set, but give her something special, you know, go to church, maybe go to have a meal and stuff like that. Just spend that time with your mother. Ain't nothing much difference than, you know, that what you guys probably may do over there in Trinidad, St. Lucia, or the United States. You know, we all seem to celebrate the same way.
Yeah, and that is giving glowing tributes to mom.
Yeah, big up all the super mama out there, man. You know what I'm saying? And all y'all women out there who not fit enough to be a mama, just don't have sex. You know what I'm saying? Just listen to me, man. Listen to me. It's too many babies come through the project. Too many kids come through the project, and we tired of that. You know what I'm saying? So if you know you can't take care of them and whatnot, just stay away. Just stay away. Protect yourself, man.
You know, funny enough, a lot of people feel that if you can, reproduce or produce or give birth, that makes you a mother. I don't think so, because there are people who have not given birth, but yet they are taking care of lots of people, and the care they are.
Oh, yes. Kids, yes.
You have no idea. I know one woman who virtually is taking care of almost about 10 kids. And look, Rocco.
Yeah. So true, Festus. So true.
She's just an awesome woman that she gives them extra care that probably this kid's fathers and mothers can't even give them. So
Wow. Most
people might feel that, if only you are having a child, that makes you a mother. No, there are a lot of people who are not giving birth yet, but yet still playing the key role of mothers. And those people need to be really celebrated, trust me.
As well, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, I've seen this with my great-grandma as well, my grandma, you know what I'm saying? They have sent a lot of kids from the community to school, you know? struggling families and stuff like that. They have really, really helped those families out with their children. So, you don't necessarily need to give birth to a child. I mean, to look at a child as we call that to be a mama. They got some really great moms out there who never give birth to a child. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, adopted mm-hmm. ones as well. Mm-hmm. Just mm-hmm.
Some great stepmothers. Even though some of them in all of that the best. You get some badass stepmom.
You know, right?
But shout out to all the good stepmamas. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to all the good ones. Yeah. aunties, you know, cousins, all the ladies who play a great role in children's life. You know, big up yourself right now.
Undoubtedly,
yes. Lady Anne, you've not told us how you're also going to celebrate yours on Sunday.
Yeah, certainly. I've been getting to that.
Roko and I, we are curious. We just want to know how you're going to celebrate yours.
Yeah, I'll surely. She know me. She know I'm coming for her head. I come for her there.
Oh, really? Oh, gosh. And I thought I would get out to it.
Okay. You're not, man. You're not going to escape from me.
You know, growing up, as a child, when I was born, my mom is the second of seven children. So she had five sisters and one brother who has passed away now, God rest his soul. And one of her sisters, my auntie, she also passed away. But when I was born, I was the first grandchild. And my mom
then
was
it seems you and Roko has certain things in common, right?
Apparently.
I am most definitely right through the line, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, and my mom was a working mom at that time, both my parents, and I practically grew up with my aunties and my grandmother. So when my mom would go to work, they would drop us off. Well, my brother and I have a younger brother, and they dropped the both of us off at my grandmother. And you know, for those listeners who are listening, you know, when in Trinidad here, we refer to our mom's mother as Nani and our father's mother as Aji, but we call my dad.
All right, well, let's be clear, you know what I'm saying? That's within the Asian culture, within the Indian culture, they would do that.
Yes, 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 yes. So I grew up with my aunties. They took care of me during the day. And my mom has a sister who is physically challenged. And her hands not so straight like, you know, most persons. And she used to hold me and rock me in a rocker, which my grandmother and they have at home when I was a baby. No matter if I was crying, and they put me in her arms, they set her down in that rocker and set up her arms and put me there. And she cradled me and rocked me, and I would stop crying. And I definitely enjoyed that. So I grew up with my aunties. They took care of me during the day. When my parents came, they took us back. We went home. And even though my mom was a working mom, she made sure. And she taught me how to wash my clothes. I remember, you know, the first things, articles of clothing, my uniform, my shirts and socks and, you know, the little underclothes and so on. She taught me how to separate it and soak it and not let this color run into that one, how to fold my clothes, make sure and iron properly, iron all your clothes for the week, don't be rushing last minute. So, you know, all the discipline my mom instilled in us, she made sure she did what she had to do. She even started to teach me how to cook. So most of the stuff that I know is from what my mom taught me. And my mom is a remarkable woman. She gave me such advice. You know, being a young lady going to school, I always remember. She instilled in me, and listeners, I know you all would have told your girl children, your daughters, this. She told me when I was going to school, she said, "Don't let any boys practice on you to kiss and that kind of thing. Because you know what? At the end of the day, they're not going to get married to you. All they want is to use is to use you to experience and to experiment and leave you there. So make sure you don't get yourself involved in that." And we had those chats regularly. And you know, I thank God for my mom for those small but really, really, I mean, great advice which she gave at that point in time. And I look forward to spending Mother's Day with my mom because it's not only with my mom. I may spend part of the day with my mom. And the other part, we go to my grandmother's house where my other aunties would come, my mom's sisters. Everybody would come and we bring something, or we go to my grandmother's house and we cook there, and all the cousins and everybody would meet up and chat. And you know, have a wonderful time just reminiscing, as they say. And my mom loves flowers, as she always says. Don't wait till I pass away and I can't see it and I can't smell it. So bring the flowers and put it here now so I will enjoy it. So it's like we start to celebrate a whole week before. We just don't wait on that particular day, a couple of days before we start to celebrate, you know, the flowers and the small little stuff before the actual day. And we look forward to going to church because our church, the Poona Open Bible Miracle Center, our pastor, Reverend Winston Mansing, makes a big deal out of Mother's Day. So we don't have the service the Sunday morning. That is left for the moms to go and celebrate with their moms and their children. So we have it the Saturday evening. And we have a really nice service. They roll out the red carpet. So when the moms come, they're stepping onto the red carpet to walk up to the door and enter into the sanctuary. And then the worship starts, and they would call, like to give the sermon that special day. They would call one of the female senior pastors or apostles from another church would come to speak to the moms, and they would do little fun things as well. You know, sometimes they may bring a pair of shoe, just have little games and so to spice up the service a little bit and let a mom come up and try off the shoe, and whoever the shoe fits, they get to keep it, or they have little door prizes. Plus they have tokens for all the moms that day. And they get the children to go around and give the moms, not only biological moms, but anyone who is a mom to other children or other individuals. They also get tokens, and we really make a
That's
big out of
amazing,
it
you know.
there. Yeah, and there is a toast for the mom with non-alcoholic wine after, you know, in these nice little champagne glasses. We make a toast to the mom, and yeah, it's really, really nice. And then you see all the moms, they deck off and they decorate the church and say, "Well, moms, you all can come and take your pictures." And it's really, really wonderful. So
So,
that is.
Lady, I'm probably I will have a question for you, maybe. So you did indicate that mommy gave you that piece of advice that don't let the boys experiment on you. Did mommy ever beat you? Did he ever spank you? Did she ever spare the rod to spoil the child?
Hell, oh my gosh. Anything we did wrong, hey, we got licks for it, I must say, but it wasn't licks in a bad way. No. Hello. Hello. Hey, my brother and I used to hide the whip. I know my mom is listening. Mom, I love you.
Well, maybe I was that lucky one. Never used to get whipped.
You know, in Africa, look, you would never spare the rod. In fact, I have really taken canes at my back. I wouldn't lie to you. Sometimes I'll come and mommy will hide the cane inside her skirt. Because immediately I see the cane, I'll run away.
Yeah.
So she will just hide it as if, oh, she will not beat me. Then she'll ask me to go. Probably I will go riding bicycle or going for mango hunt or something. Mm-hmm. And probably my dresses will be dirty. My shirt will be dirty. So you just keep quiet. Say, oh, go take your shower. And before I get to the shower and I take my bath, here comes my mom. And then, oh, she will take the cane out of her skirt. And he will give me some lashes. And from there, he will give me my supper to eat, you know.
I don't want to say like licks I used to get per se. I mean, it's like, if you want to say more like grounded, maybe like if you do something bad, like, you know, maybe you should go to your room, maybe just go take away stuff for you, man, maybe like that. But to say like licks, no. Not at all. Not really.
No, but I got to a time where she has to speak to me. One early morning, she called me and she asked me, do I want her to die? And I said, no, nobody wants to lose their mama, you know. So when she said that, I was taken aback. And it's like, wow, what is my mom telling me? So I was sharing tears and I promised her that I was going to be a good boy from that day onwards. And trust me, she saw a changed boy in me.
Oh, okay.
Well, yeah. Man, I remember one person used to try to hit me was my great aunt. My great-grandma's sister, if she was alive today, she probably would have been 106 or 7 years old. Man, sometimes, I remember one time, like, this letter, like, would it normally have on this conveyor belt? Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Man, one time, this lady, I mean, I was big in her as well, too. I mean, and something I did, I can't remember. Maybe I think she probably said, don't leave the yard. You know, that's one of the things, as boys, they will say to you, stay at home. Don't leave the yard. And, yeah, this disobey that. Oh, my gosh. And the afternoon, she called me. She's like, come and get something for me. And she was standing by the gate with that thing, hiding. And as soon as you go through the gate, oh, my God. She let go that thing in your head. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. That shit burns. It burns, you know?
Yes. Burns, but, you know, as you're speaking about that, again, you know, as children, we do stuff that we're not aware of, or sometimes, you know, just being kids. And I remember writing up the wall at my grandmother's house with crayons. And oh boy, that was something else. My dad had to go and get a gallon of paint and come and paint my grandma's wall. Honestly, because you know, it's like you take the wall from a blackboard and you write in with the crayon and it feels like.
Yeah, I mean, you back in the days, you do.
Yeah, exactly.
Back in the days, you play school, like teacher and student.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, boy, yeah, colorful. Patterns on my grandma's wall, all different colors and squiggles, and oh, that was a time. Some memories you just do not forget. Yes.
Well, you certainly just can't forget some memories. I know for me, to be honest with you, I don't know how my great grandma and them put up with it. To be honest, man, seriously, because I won't say bad per se. Maybe some people probably would think that was bad, but. Maybe just being mischievous. One of the things I remember my grandma used to always talk to me about and stuff like that is like, you know, maybe stay in the yard and then, you know, as soon as the back turn and stuff like that, you just leave and go on playing maybe football, maybe some sort of game and stuff like that. And maybe, not maybe, mischievous to an extent as well, too. You know? One of the bad things I remember my grandma used to always talk to me about, cracking of windows. Listen, thinking about it right now was so mean. You know, going around the communities like dark nighttime and pelting rocks at people's window.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. That was beautiful. I mean, the way one that rock connect with the glass. That was just so amazing, man. It was a thrill. It was a thriller, you know. Oh gosh.
You know, a beautiful memory I have being a child. Before they have all these cinemas now, you know, the movie towns, and so we had cinemas, the big screen that it was like drive-in. So you were driving with your car and there would be a big screen in front and you could stay in your car. There would be like little posts with the speakers there next to your car, or you could come out and sit on a bench or carry a chair and sit down and so. And my dad's mom and his sister, so that was my grandma and my aunt, they used to like to go to the drive-in cinema. So those shows used to show during the evening time when it's getting dusk, dark, twilight into night. And my grandmother used to make like popcorn and fry up little nuts and so. And my auntie, my grandmother and I, we would go to the drive-in cinema and take in the movie. And, you know, that's how I started looking at those Indian movies with Amitabh Bachchan, and they was on that big screen out of India. So I used to really enjoy that time spending with them.
Oh, you know, one of the interesting, before we go on a break, one of the things that seeing you so much screen that was beautiful, I remember as well, especially me and my mom, and as a kid growing up, back in those days, you call it the theater or cinema, going to the movies and stuff. Man, that was beautiful, beautiful, beautiful time, you know? You go watch the movies, and man, you get some popcorn, the ice cream. For you as a kid, that was like a big deal.
Yeah,
you know?
It's a big treat, yeah.
Yeah. That was a big deal, man, as a kid. For
me, I remember one time when, there was a drink called Palmesan, you know, and my dad used to like that drink a lot. It was alcoholic. And anytime when his friends come around, he'll go bring it from the fridge, and it's like they are sipping, they are talking, they are enjoying life. It's like, so one day, you know what I did? Also, when my dad wasn't at home, I decided that, okay, let me go taste this drink that you don't even enjoy. So
I know, brother, I know it.
I put the stools around and then I climbed the stool. So I picked the pomace from the fridge and I opened it and I was sipping. Little did I know that my mother was coming from behind. He just grabbed my shirt and asked me, what do you think you are doing?
Yeah, trust moms to have eyes all over the place. Just
what I tell you.
I was begging her not to tell daddy, because if he told daddy, I was dead. I was.
You know what, guys? We definitely need to go to commercial break, and we're gonna be back. You're listening to Art Heart on UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. I'm King Rocco HD, and I got a beautiful lady on in the studio with me, and our special guest, all the way from the motherland, all the way from Accra, Ghana, Festo. So big up to all the mamas who are listening right now. I want to say good night to all our listeners down there in Panama City, Argentina, Trinidad and Tobago, New York. Good evening to you. Miami, Florida. Good evening. North Carolina. Good evening. Houston, Texas, Michigan, California. Good evening. Also, good evening to all our listeners down there in Chicago, Illinois, and the UK and Toronto, Canada, Kingston, Jamaica. Can see you in the house as well, too. St. Lucia. Good evening. Antigua and Barbuda. And also all of our listeners right across the African continent. So you know what, let's get into this song right now. Let's take this is a beautiful song. You know what, let me just get into it and we're gonna be right back.
You taught me everything you've given me. I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life, yeah. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Oh, you were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to come.
If y'all would like to reach out to us, y'all can definitely hit us up on Zoom at 543-972-1652 or WhatsApp 646-443-6970. You're listening to Art to Heart on UBC Radio, King Rock AD, and Lady Anna and our special guest, Besto.
Mama,
yeah.
Mama, you know I love you. Ooh, you knew I love you, Mama. Mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars.
Yes, it is.
Mama, I just want you to know. Loving you is like food to my soul.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Always down for me, have always been around for me. Even when I was bad, you've shown me right from my wrongs. Yes, you did. And you took up for me when everyone was down on me. You always did understand. You gave me strength to go on.
There were so many times looking back when I was so afraid. And then you come to me and tell me I could face anything. And no one else can do what you've done for me. You'll always be, you will always be the girl in my life. Ooh, oh.
Mama, Mama, you know I love you.
You know I love you.
Time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, I'm scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years we was poor than other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blamed mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. In elementary, hey, I see the penitentiary one day. Running from the police, that's right. Mama catch me, put a whooping to my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen. Mama, I finally understand, for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did it, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Lady, don't you know we love you, sweet.
Dear mama.
Lady, please, no one above you, sweet.
You all appreciate it.
Lady, don't you know we love you.
Now ain't nobody tell us it was fair. No love for my daddy, cause the coward wasn't there. He passed away and I didn't cry, cause my anger wouldn't let me feel for a stranger. They say I'm wrong and I'm heartless, but all along I was looking for a father, he was gone. I hung around with the thugs, and even though they sold drugs, they showed a young brother love. I moved out and started really hanging. I needed money of my own, so I started slanging. I ain't guilty, cause even though I sell rocks, it feels good putting money in your mailbox. I love paying rent when the rent's due. Hope you got the diamond necklace that I sent to you. Cause when I was low, you was there for me. You never left me alone because you cared for me. And I can see you coming home after work late. You're in the kitchen trying to fix us a hot plate. You're just working with the scraps you was giving. And mama made miracles every Thanksgiving. But now the road got rough, you're alone. You're trying to raise two.
This message from Trinidad and Hi, I'm Anjali, and I'm sending this message from Trinidad and Tobago. I want to wish my mother and my grandmother and all my aunties a happy and a very blessed Mother's Day. Thank you for helping me all these past few years. You are the only lady that I always trust, and all the time I always trusted you. Today I wanted to thank you all for helping me with everything you have done to me. Everything was so special that you helped me when I was small. Thank you so much, and I have a blessed Mother's Day to you all. Thank you.
Oh, that is so sweet, isn't it? Beautiful child. Welcome back, great people, to Art Heart and UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. King Rocco AG with a beautiful lady, Anna, and our special guest all the way from Accra, Ghana, Festus. Welcome back, fams.
Okay.
Thank you.
Great to be here back. So we have some greetings to send out, and Festus will send his greetings at this time.
Yes, so I want to say a very happy Mother's Day in advance to my friend who lives in Chicago, Illinois. She's called Bridget Anani. And then to another friend, Bridget Anani. And then to Gifty Gia, she's in Massachusetts. I just want to wish them happy Mother's Day in advance, and they should enjoy it. But I'll get in touch with them on that day, so they should take care of themselves as well.
Okay, all right then. And we have another dedication going out. And Auntie Jean, all the way in Toronto, Canada, is sending a special memory, just in memory of her late mom. And that is Mungia Sonny Raman, who died on this day, 11th of May, 2023, 9 years ago. And they are just remembering their mom on this special day. So lots of love. And, you know, she is always in the hearts of her children and those who have those special treasured memories and moments. They just, again, want to remember their mom on this day today, 11th of May, 2023, when she passed away 9 years ago, the late Mungia Sonny Raman. So we've got a clip to get into at this time.
Yes, yeah, certainly. Let's get into this right now.
Everyone, give mom a little space. Hey, babe, can you just give me a minute?
Julia,
let's go, Dad.
Let's give mommy and Grammy a minute.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Well,
there you go.
Thank you, Mom.
I don't know how you did it.
Did what, honey?
Raised me without going insane. I mean, look at me, I'm a mess, but you were just a perfect mother.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were. You were always so calm and sweet with me.
That's because every moment was a joy.
I don't even remember you ever yelling at me.
How could I yell at this face?
Oh my God, look what you did to the TV! She just put paint all over the TV!
I just need a break sometimes. I'm completely overwhelmed. Did you ever feel like that?
If I did, I don't remember.
I mean, I can barely manage to take a shower every other day, but you were always so put together.
Enjoying the show, Cheryl?
Hell no.
You were perfect. I mean, even when I was a teenager and you were supposed to hate your mom, you were great. You never judged me. You never pried.
Well, it was none of my business.
little slut.
Just compared to you, I feel like I'm not good at this.
You are every bit the mother I was, and then some. Maybe you feel like this inside, but outside you come across as so relaxed.
Well, I try not to get worked up about the little stuff.
Why didn't you pack the goddamn giraffe?
You said pack a toy!
I meant a giraffe!
Didn't say sh- Hey, baby.
And it seems like you and Nick still find time to, you know.
Mom, I'll just say that in the bedroom, we're still very much a married couple. I'm sorry.
You are doing an amazing job. Just remember to cherish every moment. Because each day with your child is special.
Oh my God, Nick, can you come help me? She blew out her diaper.
What?
She has all the way up her back.
Oh, that's up to her neck.
And each day you'll experience something new and wonderful.
Hi, Dr. Klein, my daughter ate 2 crayons.
No, 5. She ate 5 crayons.
I'm sorry, 5 crayons. Do we need to bring her in? That's exactly what I needed to hear. See, you are a perfect mother.
So are you, honey. Oh.
You have poop in your hair.
Wow. Yes. We're back. Welcome back. That's a beautiful piece of poetry. Yeah, beautiful.
Touching all the hearts of the mom.
Yes,
of the moms exactly. out there. Yeah, yeah, one
exactly.
heart at a time.
It just to show you the amount of work the mom put in with kids, man. It's something else, isn't it?
Yeah, it's never ending.
Definitely, sure.
Never ending.
Okay.
Yep.
So as we get ready to wind up, guys, you want to send out your greetings before we start winding up?
Yeah, definitely. I want to say a big shout out to all the ladies out there, all the mamas out there, mothers, all the real mothers, you know what I'm saying? And all the fake ones, get real, simple as that, you know what I'm saying? And all the daddies as well, to who holding it down with their kids as well, you know. There are a lot of single fathers out there who play that active role as a mother as well, too, you know. So definitely we want to say a big shout out to all of these people who, everybody who raising children, man. You know what I'm saying? Everybody who raising children, because, you know, to say, the children today is our future leader. And, I mean, it's very important of what you are doing in that child's life, because you know what you do today, we're going to get the outcome tomorrow. So keep on doing whatever you're doing and stay focused. Yeah, just keep on doing what you're doing and stay focused. We definitely appreciate y'all. We definitely love y'all.
Mm-hmm. Festus?
Yes, so to my mom, she's called Ruby Fiamo. She's in Tema, a suburb of Accra. Mommy, I love you so much. Thank you for everything that you did for me and my siblings. We really, truly appreciate every effort, and we pray that God will keep you till when you can't keep yourself anymore. But trust me, Sunday we'll be at home and we're going to celebrate you. To the girlfriends out there, happy Mother's Day to all of them. To the fiancés out there, happy Mother's Day.
And most certainly.
Every woman Everybody. Who is playing a key role in the life of any child. Look, tremendous work that you guys are doing. We really appreciate Roku. In fact, my daughter was left in my care just for a day, and I couldn't stand it. I'm telling you, women are playing key role.
You say you can stand it?
I couldn't stand it. Look. And it's like, hey, you women, you are doing so well. And so, look, more grace to your elbows. God richly bless every woman who is hearing our voice today. God richly bless you. And keep on doing more. And we'll celebrate all of you. God bless you all.
God bless you indeed. Women always have an important role in our society. From many, many years ago and onto a day like today, women do have an important role in our lives, in society.
Yes, yes, we do. And I would just like to remind all the parents out there, do not anger your children. And when you speak with your children, you speak with that gentle tone. You remember that you have, you know, you put God first when you speak into them, reason with them, and do not discipline your children when you are angry. That is not good. Sometimes you say things that you should not say, or the beatings are a little more severe than they really should be, the little lashes and so forth. And I just want to wish all the moms of UVC Happy Mother's Day. Also all the listeners out there, yeah! Enjoy your day on Sunday, whatever you do. God's choices, blessings. I am really looking forward to spending the day with my mom on Sunday. And the listeners, join me on Sunday morning, 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. Eastern Caribbean Standard Time for Sunrise Praise, where definitely we will be celebrating moms again on that day, Mother's Day. So we love each and every one of you. Thank you all for tuning in. And it has been a delightful one having Festus here with us. Looking forward to doing it lots more. And King Rocco, definitely a pleasure with you as always.
As you rightly say, you know, we want to wish all the moms right across the globe a happy Mother's Day. Keep on doing what you're doing. We love y'all. You know what I'm saying? We definitely appreciate y'all, and we love y'all. And just stay focused, man. Sometimes it can be hard. Sometimes it can be really frustrated. You have done everything and anything under the sun to try to keep your child in check. And, you know, sometimes, unfortunately, everything that you have done, it seems to go by the wayside. But you know what? Listen, what I want to tell you right now, don't feel bad. You know what I'm saying? Don't feel you let yourself down. You have done everything that you can. You have done everything that you could. You know what I'm saying? So keep on doing what you're doing. Just stay focused and just don't lose faith. You know what I mean? Because the time, unfortunately, Anna, that we're living, you know, it's really difficult, to be honest with you. Whether a mother or whether for a father raising children and stuff like that, it's really, really difficult. And, we want to have support. Family support is very important. Community support is very important. Church support is very important. We need to support our women. And we need to support our single dads as well too. You know what I'm saying? Because as Festus rightly said, you know, he was left in the care with his daughter for a day and was hard. So you can imagine some single daddy got 2, 3, 4 kids just doing it on their own and still got to go and do a regular 9-to-5. That shit is hard as hell, man. You know what I'm saying? So, big up everybody who's holding it down, man. Love ya. So, you know what? In the meantime, between time, stay tuned. Tomorrow, Friday, we got the Fiery Zone tomorrow. And we got some wonderful program for the rest of the week. So, y'all better stay tuned. So, once again, happy Mother's Day. We're out. Peace. Love ya.
For my mama, where would I be? Where would I be, Lord? Where would I be? Where would I be without my mama? Mommy, me love you, there's nothing I'd put above you. No house, nor no girl, nor no car. Stand firm in all my life, nothing about you. From a barn, me and you are par. Mommy, yeah! I'm a princess, mommy, I'm a dancer. I'm a life, you love me, understand. Special dedication to the big woman. From your love, your mama, hey! I see you on. Supposed to belong to your mama, like a for your mama. Select her, you better pull up the one you for your mama. Proud of your mama, sing loud for your mama. Yeah, hey, I'll let you know you're happy. She be a good
man. When you want to listen to Lady and King Rock up on UBC Radio. Leave me alone and turn up the radio.
Mama,
Christ's teachings, and in the scripture she placed her beliefs in. Real thing, if I never mama, I wouldn't believe it. So go sablang for your mama, lighter for your mama. Selector, you better pull up the one you for your mama. Proud of your mama, sing loud for your mama. Yeah, I make sure you know you're happy, she bring you come here. From your heart, help me sing this one. From your love, your mama like this man. There's no one like my mama, no, no. Hey yo, I feel my mama this, yes, I feel my mama this. You we gave a birth, I'm last, yes, all of this. I feel my mama this, yes, I feel my mama this. Anything you want, you want, get me, so we promise. So anything you want, anything at all, anything you need, my mama, no friend for God. And this year is a sun fire. So go stop long for your mama, light up for your mama.
Leave me alone and turn up the radio.